people don't even know what a music therapist is or how we are trained. And that might help with the understanding in the beginning. First of all, we have to have a major instrument, and the medium is the message, so we can't just be mediocre musicians. We have to be fairly decent musicians. We may not be musicians with the same skills as Penny or as Drew. Myself, I went to the Cincinnati Conservatory. I was a voice major and a piano minor, and it was later that I went into music therapy. But we, in addition to whatever instrument we learn, I would still, as a music therapy major, have to take piano, voice, and guitar, because those are the instruments we use most. Actually, in the hospital setting, my voice was number one, because there were times that I would go in with a patient and I couldn't take anything else with me. It might be that I was dressed head to toe in sterile gear, or that the patient couldn't tolerate any more than the gentle stimulation of my very soft voice. We also take coursework that looks much like a music educator's coursework. So theory, music history, we participate in ensembles, chorales. We have to have a general knowledge of all instruments. We also take psychology and child development, different mental health courses. And then there are music therapy courses that are very specific to music therapy, such as the psychology of music. You can't even believe what's in that course. I took it a long time ago, but we might talk about how does tempo affect us? How does tempo affect our heart rates? How does it tempo affect our sleep? What keys are conducive to certain things? What modes do we want to be concerned about? How does harmony and dissonance impact us? I think last, but certainly not least, because it's something that defines us as a music therapist, we need to learn how to assess our patients or our clients. We don't just go in and play music. We learn about the patient, we read their chart, we maybe speak with the physician or the person who gave us the referral, which could be, it could be a physician, it could be a nurse practitioner, it could be a social worker, and tell us a little bit about the patient, know what the medical treatment is. We consider from evidence-based research how we want to approach this patient, and then we go in and provide treatment, and then we examine what we've done.
What's the difference between a therapeutic music or musician and what a music therapist does? And I think we have to start from a very basic level, which is, what's my training? My training is as a performer, as a player. I know how to play my instrument to a certain level. That's it. That's all you know. When you know that I'm an orchestral musician, you know that I can play my instrument at a certain level. I can play orchestral music at a certain level. That's all you know about me, which means that there are a lot of musicians who may or may not then have the other skills that are necessary to be effective working in a team with a music therapist. Part of that for the musicians is going into an environment without your instrument and just listening. I remember going to a drum circle that was in a homeless shelter in Philadelphia, and there happened to be two Philadelphia Orchestra violinists there who were supposed to be participating in the event, but it was led by a music therapist. And I ended up playing one of the drums. Well, what does that do as far as my relationship to the homeless people? I'm on the same plane. I don't know how to play a percussion instrument. They don't necessarily either, but it means that we're kind of on level footing. I'm discovering, they're discovering. So we had a different conversation than if I'd had an instrument. When I was playing, just working out sort of an interactive way with some of the refugee children, this piece seemed to speak to them a lot. And It's called Skyboat Song, and of course you have to use your imagination what the accompaniment's like, but I just said, imagine that you're in a boat and the boat's slightly swaying.